I'm now going to go through the examination of the lymph nodes systematically from head to toe. Examination of the lymph nodes is important in people who may have infectious diseases, fevers, or any evidence of lymphadenopathy in any of the regional beds. So be sure to clean your hands, as always, before examining the patient. This reassures the patient as well as protecting both of you. First thing, you need to know where the lymph node beds are. In the head, submental, submandibular, the anterior triangle down the front of the sternocleidomastoid, turn your chin towards me, so the sternocleidomastoid here, along the posterior triangle, along the back of the sternocleidomastoid, anterior to the trapezius muscle, and then in the occipital region under the occiput. The supraclavicular fossa on both sides, and then the infraclavicular fossa. Preauricular and postauricular nodes should also be checked. There are actually some diseases for which nodes in that area are quite specific. So now let's go through the exam. We'll now palpate these lymph node beds. I examine three of the lymph node beds from the front. The preauricular, right here in front of the ear, postauricular, and the occipital. I examine the occipital from the front because your hands palpate very easily in this position. So you just reach around to the occiput and you're palpating right underneath the occiput and then forward and then down the back of the neck, rolling the tissue underneath your fingers. Okay, and then I move to the back in order to palpate the front of the neck. Again, the hands palpate very comfortably in this position. You can palpate the submental and submandibular nodes. And I like to do it symmetrically, so I'm palpating both at the same time in this position. And then down the front of the sternocleidomastoid, retract the muscle a little bit so you ensure you're feeling under the anterior border. And then right down to the insertion of the sternocleidomastoid, and pay particular attention in this area. A famous node called Virchow's node may be palpated right here under the head of the left sternocleidomastoid and indicate carcinoma or problems coming up from the abdomen. Then we come down the posterior aspect of the sternocleidomastoid in the posterior triangle, along the anterior border of the trapezius bilaterally. And lastly, the supraclavicular fossa on both sides, extending out laterally from the heads of the sternocleidomastoid. Good. And that completes the examination of the lymph node beds in the head and neck. Next, we'll move on to examination of the lymph node beds in the chest. Start by exposing the chest, and we'll point out where the major lymph node beds are. Now we're moving below the clavicle. Clavicle defines the upper part of the chest itself, the infraclavicular nodes in this area, and the axillary lymph node beds. And these are fairly complex. They exist under the border of the pectoralis muscle, in the apex, under the border of the latissimus dorsi here, and then also in the down the axillary artery and vein. And it's necessary to palpate all of those areas, and I'll demonstrate that now. We're now going to examine the lymph node beds of the torso, starting with the infraclavicular fossa just below the clavicle. And this area is palpated over the pectoralis minor muscle and then up into towards the coracoid process on both sides. Next, we're going to move to the axilla. The axilla is a complex area. And there are several lymph node beds we need to pay attention to. Along the border of the pectoralis major, into the apex of the axilla, along the anterior border of the latissimus dorsi, actually down into the middle of the axilla, and then lastly, along the neurovascular bundle as it comes out into the arm. And we need to palpate each one of those lymph node beds. It's important that the shoulder be completely relaxed when we do this, since we're trying to palpate under the muscles that actually influence the shoulder. So I start by taking the palm of my hand with the fingers extended, pushing it high into the axilla, and then raking down with my fingers while relaxing the shoulder down. And you're trying to roll any lymph nodes down along. So it's up here, and then you're raking down with your hand to try to catch those lymph nodes. Next, palpate under the under the pectoralis muscle. Right down the border of the pectoralis, and then along the border of the posterior fold of the axilla, which is the latissimus dorsi. And lastly, with the other hand, it's easy to palpate up in the apex and down the neurovascular bundle as it descends into the arm. Sometimes it may be preferable to palpate the posterior axillary fold from behind. Again, supporting the patient's arm, trying to get him to completely relax that arm, and then your fingers come underneath the anterior border of the the latissimus dorsi, and feel for nodes in that area tucked underneath the muscle. And that completes the examination of the right axilla. Notice that most of the exam was done with the left hand, and then we'll repeat the process when we move to the left side using the right hand for much of the examination. We're now going to examine the left axilla. Once again, it's important that the shoulder be completely relaxed by supporting it with your left hand, and most of the examination is going to be done with your right hand. So we start with the fingertips placed high up in the axilla. Remember, we're going to examine the lymph node beds high in the axilla and down the lateral chest wall, underneath the posterior border of the pectoralis major, underneath the anterior border of the latissimus dorsi, and then down the neurovascular bundle as it descends into the arm. So first we put the fingertips high in the axilla, fair amount of pressure here, and rake the fingertips down the chest wall. Any enlarged lymph nodes will slide underneath your finger. Next, fingertips go under the border of the pectoralis major, sliding the muscle out of the way so you can get underneath and feel against the chest wall. And then similarly, on the posterior axillary fold, underneath the anterior border of the latissimus dorsi. Okay. And lastly, feeling down the neurovascular bundle. Personally, I find that this may be easier to do switching hands and doing it with your left hand in this position. On occasion, you may prefer to feel the lymph nodes along the border of the latissimus dorsi from behind. Again, so relax the shoulder here. And then we're going to feel under the anterior border using the fingertips. This allows you to really get your fingertips under the border. This can be uncomfortable for the patient, so be gentle and feel along the chest wall as well. Lastly, don't forget to feel the epitrochlear lymph nodes that are right here behind the elbow in this area. And they may be enlarged with problems in the hands and forearms. Okay. Another way to examine the axilla is to support the patient's arm on your examining hand and then to place your other hand, in this case the left hand, on the shoulder, and this helps compress the tissue and bring it down into the area where you're examining. You can also use that to help manipulate the pectoralis on this side. So this is an instance when you're using both hands. Again, you're going to support the arm on your examining hand and use the opposite hand to bring the shoulder down so that the tissues are brought into approximation. And you can actually use bimanual palpation between your two fingers in this with this technique. So that's another useful way to examine the axilla. After completing the examination of the axilla, head, and neck, we're going to now move to the inguinal lymph nodes. We ask the patient to lie down on his back. And then we're going to examine the inguinal areas individually. To examine the inguinal ligaments, we're going to do that one side at a time. And you want to expose the area from the anterior superior iliac spine over to the symphysis pubis. The inguinal ligament runs in this direction, and the lymph node beds are inferior and oftentimes a little medial to that. So again, start well above that area, palpating with the flat of your hand and rolling the tissue along. You know you're in the right area when you can palpate the femoral artery, which I am right there. Remember, the lymph nodes run along the neurovascular bundle. So you're basically following that area down into the leg. You want to extend at least 8 to 10 centimeters anteriorly, and don't forget to palpate medially as well, right over to the symphysis pubis. Okay, and then we just repeat that on the other side, again exposing the area, anterior iliac spine down to symphysis pubis, inguinal ligament runs here. Femoral artery is right here, and we will just palpate under and inferior to the inguinal ligament, rolling the tissue and again continuing down the anterior aspect of the thigh 8 to 10 centimeters and extending medially and right over here to the symphysis pubis. And that completes the examination of the inguinal lymph nodes. Very common to feel small, less than 1 centimeter inguinal lymph nodes that are perfectly normal. And that completes the lymph node examination. The posterior axillary fold from behind, again supporting the patient's arm, trying to get him to completely relax that arm, and then your fingers come underneath the anterior border of the the latissimus dorsi, and feel for nodes in that area tucked underneath the muscle. And that completes the examination of the right axilla. Notice that most of the exam was done with the left hand. And then we'll repeat the process when we move to the left side using the right hand for much of the examination. We're now going to examine the left axilla. Once again, it's important that the shoulder be completely relaxed by supporting it with your left hand. And most of the examination is going to be done with your right hand. So we start with the fingertips placed high up in the axilla. Remember, we're going to examine the lymph node beds high in the axilla and down the lateral chest wall, underneath the posterior border of the pectoralis major, underneath the anterior border of the latissimus dorsi, and then down the neurovascular bundle as it descends into the arm. So first we put the fingertips high in the axilla, fair amount of pressure here, and rake the fingertips down the chest wall. Any enlarged lymph nodes will slide underneath your finger. Next, fingertips go under the border of the pectoralis major, sliding the muscle out of the way so you can get underneath and feel against the chest wall. And then similarly, on the posterior axillary fold, underneath the anterior border of the latissimus dorsi. Okay. And lastly, feeling down the neurovascular bundle. Personally, I find that this may be easier to do switching hands and doing it with your left hand in this position. On occasion, you may prefer to feel the lymph nodes along the border of the latissimus dorsi from behind. Again, so relax the shoulder here. And then we're going to feel under the lymph node beds of the torso, starting with the infraclavicular fossa just below the clavicle. And this area is palpated over the pectoralis minor muscle and then up into towards the coracoid process on both sides. Next, we're going to move to the axilla. The axilla is a complex area. And there are several lymph node beds we need to pay attention to. Along the border of the pectoralis major, into the apex of the axilla, along the anterior border of the latissimus dorsi, actually down into the middle of the axilla, and then lastly, along the neurovascular bundle as it comes out into the arm. And we need to palpate each one of those lymph node beds. It's important that the shoulder be completely relaxed when we do this, since we're trying to palpate under the muscles that actually influence the shoulder. So I start by taking the palm of my hand with the fingers extended, pushing it high into the axilla, and then raking down with my fingers while relaxing the shoulder down. And you're trying to roll any lymph nodes down along. So it's up here, and then you're raking down with your hand to try to catch those lymph nodes. Next, palpate under the under the pectoralis muscle. Right down the border of the pectoralis, and then along the border of the posterior fold of the axilla, which is the latissimus dorsi. And lastly, with the other hand, it's easy to palpate up in the apex and down the neurovascular bundle as it descends into the arm. Sometimes it may be preferable to palpate. You can palpate the submental and submandibular nodes. And I like to do it symmetrically, so I'm palpating both at the same time in this position. And then down the front of the sternocleidomastoid, retract the muscle a little bit so you ensure you're feeling under the anterior border. And then right down to the insertion of the sternocleidomastoid, and pay particular attention in this area. The famous node called Virchow's node may be palpated right here under the head of the left sternocleidomastoid and indicate carcinoma or problems coming up from the abdomen. Then we come down the posterior aspect of the sternocleidomastoid in the posterior triangle, along the anterior border of the trapezius bilaterally. And lastly, the supraclavicular fossa on both sides, extending out laterally from the heads of the sternocleidomastoid. Good. And that completes the examination of the lymph node beds in the head and neck. Next, we'll move on to examination of the lymph node beds in the chest. Start by exposing the chest, and we'll point out where the major lymph node beds are. Now we're moving below the clavicle. clavicle defines the upper part of the chest itself, the infraclavicular nodes in this area, and the axillary lymph node beds. And these are fairly complex. They exist under the border of the pectoralis muscle, in the apex, under the border of the latissimus dorsi here, and then also in the down the axillary artery and vein. And it's necessary to palpate all of those areas, and I'll demonstrate that now. We're now going to examine the I'm now going to go through the examination of the lymph nodes systematically from head to toe. Examination of the lymph nodes is important in people who may have infectious diseases, fevers, or any evidence of lymphadenopathy in any of the regional beds. So be sure to clean your hands, as always, before examining the patient. This reassures the patient as well as protecting both of you. First thing, you need to know where the lymph node beds are. In the head, submental, submandibular, the anterior triangle down the front of the sternocleidomastoid, turn your chin towards me, so the sternocleidomastoid here, along the posterior triangle, along the back of the sternocleidomastoid, anterior to the trapezius muscle, and then in the occipital region under the occiput. The supraclavicular fossa on both sides, and then the infraclavicular fossa. Preauricular and postauricular nodes should also be checked. There are actually some diseases for which nodes in that area are quite specific. So now let's go through the exam. We'll now palpate these lymph node beds. I examine three of the lymph node beds from the front. The preauricular, right here in front of the ear, postauricular, and the occipital. I examine the occipital from the front because your hands palpate very easily in this position. So you just reach around to the occiput, and you're palpating right underneath the occiput, and then forward, and then down the back of the neck, rolling the tissue underneath your fingers. Okay, and then I move to the back in order to palpate the front of the neck. Again, the hands palpate very comfortably in this position. The anterior border using the fingertips, this allows you to really get your fingertips under the border. This can be uncomfortable for the patient, so be gentle and feel along the chest wall as well. Lastly, don't forget to feel the epitrochlear lymph nodes that are right here behind the elbow in this area. And they may be enlarged with problems in the hands and forearms. Okay. Another way to examine the axilla is to support the patient's arm on your examining hand, and then to place your other hand, in this case the left hand, on the shoulder, and this helps compress the tissue and bring it down into the area where you're examining. You can also use that to help manipulate the pectoralis on this side. So this is an instance when you're using both hands. Again, you're going to support the arm on your examining hand and use the opposite hand to bring the shoulder down so that the tissues are brought into approximation. And you can actually use bimanual palpation between your two fingers in this with this technique. So that's another useful way to examine the axilla. After completing the examination of the axilla, head, and neck, we're going to now move to the inguinal lymph nodes. We ask the patient to lie down on his back. And then we're going to examine the inguinal areas individually. To examine the inguinal ligaments, we're going to do that one side at a time, and you want to expose the area from the anterior superior iliac spine over to the symphysis pubis. The inguinal ligament runs in this direction, and the lymph node beds are inferior and oftentimes a little medial to that. So again, start well above that area, palpating with the flat of your hand, and rolling the tissue along.